In February of 1972, Richard Prince, Mike Hodge, Ivan Brandon, LaBarbara Bowman, Leon Dash, Penny Mickelbury, and Ronald Taylor stood together as a collective voice fighting for change. They came to be known as the Metro Seven. The seven reporters, fed up with how the Washington Post was denying black employees equal opportunities, submitted a three-page memo to their executive editor. After 7 weeks of unsuccessful negotiations with management, the group filed an official complaint with the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, charging the newspaper with discrimination against its black employees. On March 23, 1972, the Metro 7 stood on the doorstep of the Metropolitan AME Church and publicly announced their EEOC complaint, speaking about unfair racial practices that were occurring behind the prestigious newspaper's walls. Their announcement sparked conversations and concerns in newsrooms across the nation. The EEOC voted against the filing, but due to the Metro 7's courageous stand for racial equality in newsrooms, discrimination cases against the Post and other major publications were filed by other groups. In 1978, the American Society of Newspaper Editors adopted a goal of achieving racial parity in newsrooms across the nation by the year 2000. Believed to be the first of its kind against a major American newspaper, the Metro 7's stand for justice played a significant role in accelerating the hiring and promotion of scores of journalists of color. 2019 NABJ Hall of Fame recipients, the Metro 7, fighting for equality.